optimum controller settings for PID controller. There is a third method is there that is called 1/4 decay ratio method. 1/4 decay ratio method. We cannot, already I told you that if the process has a large time constant, say level, pressure, temperature, we cannot put the process in sustained oscillation. Sometimes it's difficult to keep, get the reaction curve also. It's very difficult to get reaction curve also. In that case, we can do this one. In that case, you can go for this method. This is also a closed loop method. This is also a closed loop method. In that case, suppose you are doing this method for a level process, means this is the level process. Level transmitter will be there. This PV is given to controller, level controller. Set point is given for level controller. The output of this level controller given to I2P. I2P output is given to, I2P. The I2P output is given to control valve. You put the process in closed loop and bring the first step is bring the process. Process to nominal operating point. Then do 1+ transfer. And bring the process to closed loop in open loop. This is in open loop. Initially, it is in open loop. Bring the process to nominal operating point. Then do the 1+ transfer to bring the process to closed loop. Then increase the gain. Here, in the flow process, I want to mention one thing here. You are increasing controller gain gradually till it exhibits sustained oscillation, I told you. Suppose there is no disturbance in the process, means the process is settled at some value. The process is settled at set point. That time, if you are going go on, increases the gain. What is the error? What is the error? Set point equal to PV. Then what is the error? Zero. No disturbance is entering in the process. That's why even though you increase the controller gain, it will not give any controller output. That's why it will not exhibit sustained oscillation. But flow process is slightly turbulent. That's why definitely there will be a noise. Disturbance will be there. That's why it exhibits sustained oscillation. Some error should go for that gain. Then only it will exhibit sustained oscillation. In practice, it will do. You understand that? If set point equal to PV, that time if you increase gain, it will not exhibit any sustained oscillation. It will not exhibit any sustained oscillation unless otherwise we give any disturbance or set point change. You have to give set point change or disturbance. Then only it will exhibit sustained oscillation. But here, why it automatically gives sustained oscillation means always some disturbance is coming in a flow process. But in the level process, we may not expect. Sometimes the disturbance may not come. Come, then okay. Some small error is sufficient to perturbate the process. So you have to perturbate the process of changing that controller gain. And you have to see if it is No disturbance means you have to perturbate. But here, we are going to change the set point. In this method, we are going to change the set point. It is settled at nominal level. We gave some controller gain. Now we are giving what mode? Only P only mode. Put the process in P only mode. Put the controller in. The first step is put the controller in P only mode. P only mode. Put the controller in this. I didn't mention earlier. Put the controller in P only mode. Like a sustained oscillation method, here also we have to put the controller in P only mode. Bring the process in nominal operating point in open loop. Do bumpless transfer. That is, bring the process from open loop to closed loop. Now set point equal to PV. That time, you gave some controller gain. Say, K1. Controller gain is K1. That time, you give a small step change. Give step change in set point. Give step change in set point. Give step change in set point. What will happen? The level will increase because P only controller. That's why you can expect a response like this. This is set point old. This is set point new. Set point new. The response will be looking like this. Get the response. Servo response. Give set point change and get servo response. Once you get the servo response, find the decay ratio. Decay ratio means first peak is called A, second peak is called B. Find decay ratio equal to B by A, amplitude of B divided by amplitude of A. If it is 1 by 4, you got KC. If it is 1 by 4, next step is, if it is 1 by 4, if it is DR equal to 1 by 4, then the present value of KC is the optimum value. Directly you got KC. Suppose it is not 1 by 4. It is not 1 by 4. It is greater than 1 by 4. 1 by 2, let us assume. 1 by 2. 1 by 2 or 1 by 3, greater value. It means we have to decrease the gain because gain is higher. That's why second peak also higher. It will oscillate for more time. If you increase gain, oscillation will increase. We know that. If you increase KC, Zeta will decrease. That's why the amplitude of oscillation will increase. Instead of 1 by 4, you got 1 by 2. It is higher than 1 by 4. That's why we have to decrease the gain. Suppose you got 1 by 5 or 1 by 6 or 1 by 8 you got. In that case, what is happening? Gain is less. That's why we have to increase to 1 by 4. So, till you get 1 by 4, you have to repeat this experiment. Repeat servo response. Repeat servo response. Till you get 1/4 as decay ratio. 1/4 as decay ratio. Repeat servo response till you get 1/4 as decay ratio. Once you got decay ratio, correct decay ratio, find the period of oscillation. Where the peak is here, it starts here. It starts the peak here. That is T, not ultimate. That is T decay ratio method. TD, we can put decay ratio method. TR. TR also another name for TA. That's why let us call it as DR. TDR. Sometimes TA can be called as TR. TDR. First peak to second peak, time taken for first peak to second peak is called TR, TDR. If you know TDR, we can find TI. TI equal to TDR divided by 6 and TD equal to TDR divided by 1.5. We can find the PID tuning parameters. We can find the PID tuning parameters by using this method. KC equal to what? KC equal to KC at which servo response has 1/4 decay ratio. KC equal to KC at which servo response has 1/4 decay ratio. That's all. We got the three tuning parameters. Once you get these three, from this we can estimate for P and P I controllers. We have to do the reverse engineering to find for P and PI controllers. This method will give tuning parameters for Ziegler Nichols suggested for PID. From this, you can estimate for PI and P controllers. This is called 1/4 decay ratio method. 1/4 decay ratio method. We have to do repeatedly servo response till you get 1/4 decay ratio. One-fourth decay ratio or damped oscillation method. The another name for this is damped oscillation method. Damped oscillation. Because here, it is not sustained oscillation. It is damped oscillation. Its amplitude decreases. Another name for this is damped oscillation method.